come here today to the site of the school that I attended as a boy to tell you that I will not run for re-election.
After serving New Mexicans for decades, the man they call St. Pete says goodbye.
It's almost for me like the heart of New Mexico just stood still for a minute.
The six-term U.S. Senator and national power broker will not run again.
I hear a lot of people talking about big shoes to fill, but those shoes can't be filled.
Good evening, everyone. Today, U.S. Senior Senator Domenici made the biggest announcement of his 35-year career.
The announcement that it was all coming to an end. Senator Pete Domenici was first elected and has held that office since 1972. But the six-term senator will say goodbye to his current job in Washington, D.C. in January 2009. We begin our team coverage tonight with a look at Senator Domenici's speech.
Has to be bittersweet. I guess, you know, it's kind of one of these difficult, happy days.
Eyewitnesses to history filed into St. Mary's School to honor a living legend.
He's a giant among people.
Jammed into a gym where Pete Domenici played sports as a high school boy, the man capped off a career few will ever match.
We've accomplished so much and we've made our state so much a better place to live and grow.
Domenici said he made his decision not to run again because of a degenerative brain disease. A medical exam last month revealed progression of the incurable brain disorder known as frontotemporal lobar degeneration, or FLTD.
The progress of this disease is apparently erratic and unpredictable. It may well be that 7 years from now, it will be stable. On the other hand, it may also be that it will have incapacitated me.
The senator's health became an issue after he suffered nerve damage in 1999 while playing football on Thanksgiving with his grandkids. Today, flanked by those same grandkids and more relatives, one of the state's most powerful men acknowledged where he received his strength.
No one has been as inspirational and supportive as my wife, Nancy.
A lot of applause and emotion there at today's speech. You know, when he came in, it was, of course, uproarious laughter when he ended, as we just heard right there, and more uproarious laughter. And quite often throughout his prepared speech of about, I'd say, maybe 15 minutes, they just, you know, a lot of people, there wasn't a lot of dry eyes. I mean, there were some tears, but, I mean, a lot of pride. I mean,
sure.
New Mexicans are definitely proud of Senator Pete Domenici.
What a way to go out on top like that.
Sure.
Now, the name Domenici in New Mexico has been a powerful and recognized name for four decades. What is it like growing up Domenici and having a father who is a major player in American politics? New at 10, Action 7 News reporter Chris Amidas spoke with the senior senator's family.
Well, growing up, a son or a daughter of a U.S. senator may seem glamorous with all those distinguished trips to Washington and all, but it turns out that being Lisa Domenici, one of eight children, is probably more normal than you think.
By the time Lisa Domenici turned the tender age of 14, her father was already a political figure in New Mexico and newly elected to the U.S. Senate.
I used to tell friends we just had a basically pretty normal life. There were eight of us. We were always, you know, we lived out in the suburbs and drove big station wagons. And I think more than anything, wished that he was home a little bit more.
To us, Pete Domenici is the lawmaker we've grown to know, and on occasion we'll catch him wearing that bolo tie. But to Lisa, Pete is simply dad.
When he was home, he was just dad. We used to joke about his favorite baseball cap that he would wear, that, you know, he's very unpretentious, have fish hooks hanging out of his hat. He's just a wonderful regular guy.
And though the nation and the state he served are concerned about his ailing health, no one is concerned more than his family, who surrounded him on this day he had been dreading.
Part of it is just accepting that our parents are getting older and really enjoying and taking time to enjoy every precious moment. And it makes me want to be with him more.
By the time Domenici serves out his sixth term, he will have spent 36 years serving New Mexico in Washington. For Lisa Domenici, that's more than three quarters of her life.
I'm really, really proud of him. I think it's probably the hardest decision he's ever made.
Many of Senator Domenici's children and grandchildren live right here in Albuquerque. No word yet if the senator and his wife will move back to New Mexico permanently, once his term ends in January of 2009. Reporting downtown, Chris Ramirez, KOAT Action 7 News.
And as we mentioned, the disease the senator suffers is FTLB. It is a form of dementia. HealthBeat's Dr. Barry Ramo explains what that disease does.
The disease differs from Alzheimer's because people don't lose their memory with this disease. What they do lose are the higher cerebral functions, like reasoning, being able to understand complex information, and also being able to make appropriate decisions. The other characteristic of the disease is there's often personality change. There can be motor problems as well, but those are the predominant features of this disease which distinguish it from Alzheimer's. Well, as far as treatment for this disease, there is no specific treatment. The two drugs that are used for Alzheimer's disease have been tried for this disease, but aren't really very effective. There are some experimental approaches that are being used to use electrical stimulation in parts of the brain that are involved, primarily when people have difficulty with their speech. But right now, there's certainly and unfortunately no evidence that there's any possibility of a cure. I think it's impossible to know what the prognosis is at this time. It has a variable prognosis. One would hope, certainly, that he could make it through the 15 months. He looked pretty good today, and I spoke to his campaign chairman this morning who said that he's doing just fine.
For 36 years, election after election, Pete Domenici easily defended his U.S. Senate seat. Now the race for his seat is on. The publication The Hill reports Congresswoman Heather Wilson will run for that position and should announce it, they say, maybe tomorrow. Action 7 News political reporter Matt Grubbs talks to our political analyst Brian Sanderoff, who says candidates won't waste any time deciding if they'll run.
I will not run for re-election to the United States Senate.
Pete Domenici's announcement even caught his own re-election campaign off guard. Just Monday, letters went out to supporters asking for their help getting the signatures required to get the senator back on the ballot. 3 days later, Pete Domenici said he will step down. Tomorrow, the race begins to fill a vacant seat in the U.S. Senate.
They don't come up often, and the odds are the person who wins this election will be there for a while. So that's when you have many, many people get in.
KOAT political analyst Brian Sanderoff says the race will be expensive, which means candidates need to get in as soon as possible, especially if they face a challenge in the party primaries next June. The sooner they declare, the sooner they can raise money, the sooner they can get the word out and their name known. Besides name recognition, there is one thing that will help a candidate above all else, and that is money. There are four potential candidates who already have it, New Mexico's three congressional representatives and its governor.
Campaign laws allow any money raised for federal office to be used in a different federal campaign, from the House to the Senate, even from a presidential campaign to the Senate. Bill Richardson's aides say, quote, been there, done that, with respect to the Senate seat. Brian Sanderoff says, not quite.
The House is one out of 435, whereas to be one of the 100 states, U.S. senators in the nation is a pretty amazing position.
Whoever's running, Sanderoff says, they need to make up their mind to start running soon. In Albuquerque, Matt Grubbs, KOAT Action 7 News.
We broke the story of Domenici's decision and his choice not to run is having a huge impact all across the state.
When we look back in history, you're going to see his fingerprints on every agency that's currently, every department that currently has a law enforcement mission.
And those fingerprints are in every corner of New Mexico. For example, in Artesia, Domenici secured the cash to establish the Federal Law Enforcement Training Center.
We don't call him St. Pete for nothing. We look to him to bail us out in the Senate.
In Los Alamos, workers for the National Lab credit him for getting funding for their work through Congress. With federal budget proposals looking to slash lab money, Domenici's decision has some people nervous.
When it rains, it pours. What a disaster it is.
Perhaps people at LANL can look south to Albuquerque, where the senator is credited for saving Kirtland Air Force Base from the Base Realignment and Closure Commission. KOAT military analyst Colonel Charlie Thomas was there when the senator convinced the defense secretary to keep Kirtland open.
Secretary Perry said, this is a great briefing. If you're right, I'll pull Kirtland off the list. And Senator leaned across the desk and said, I'm going to hold you to that.
And the athlete and the six-term senator may have played a part in his securing more than $1.5 million to fix Ricketts Field, a key assist in keeping the Connie Mack World Series in the Four Corners. President Bush released a statement thanking Senator Domenici for his service.
New Mexicans joined the president in thanking the senator as well, as you might expect. Action 7 News reporter Lee Chekstad has more. The legacy his friends and co-workers say he will leave behind.
Senator Domenici spent years going to school here at St. Mary's School. We spoke to those who went to school with him and those who knew him throughout his political career. In any snapshot of today's crowd, you see those who have known the senator in the past and the present.
He was several grades ahead of me when I went to St. Mary's, and I've known him practically all my life.
I've been fortunate that I've worked with him, worked for him.
My grandfather worked on his first campaign back in the 70s.
Each felt it was important to come show respect for a man who dedicated his life to making New Mexico better. And each has a way they'll remember a friend.
And always being available. If you had an issue, it was not a, you know, you could reach out to him.
We're going to have a great loss for New Mexico. And people should know that it's very important.
While most of the crowd knew him here in New Mexico, Bernalillo County Sheriff Darren White was able to see firsthand his impact in Washington.
And the minute you tell them that you were from New Mexico, the first thing they'd go is, oh, Senator Domenici. And it was amazing how that opened up so many doors because of what that man meant to the Senate. The man is legendary in this state, and his mark is everywhere.
Senator Domenici had friends come from all over New Mexico to hear him announce the end of his political career. In downtown Albuquerque, Lee Chekstad, KOAT, Action 7 News.
You saw that tight shot of People for Pete button. The first thing he did was he walked in, the big applause. He walks over to the podium. He sees somebody wearing it. He walks away. People are wondering, where are you going? Walks over, has the person, says, I want that, I want that. They hand him the button. He puts it on.
Yeah, I know. I was doing the live cut in, and I had already tossed to him at the podium.
There it goes.
And he walked off the podium. I'm like, what's happening here? Well, a big question now is, who will run for Senator Domenici's Senate seat?
And we wanted to know what you think. On our website, we asked you, who you would like to see replace Senator Domenici in our U.S. Senate? Now, some of the opinions are Albuquerque Mayor Martin Chavez, Governor Bill Richardson, or Congresswoman Heather Wilson. More than 1,000 of you already voted. So far, Albuquerque's mayor leads with 28%, Congresswoman Heather Wilson 23%, and a distant third, kind of surprising to some, our governor at 17%. Now to vote, go to our website, KOAT.com, and cast your votes.